South Boston, Virginia is in what is known as Southern Virginia. It's rural Virginia. And historically, our economy was really tied to the farm and factory economy. And I was born and raised here, so I remember when things were really good economically. But we had a lot of economic hits over the past decades. And one of the wonderful things about having the Southern Virginia Higher Education Center in what is functionally an educational desert is that we know, and our community leaders knew 32 years ago when we first got started, that if we were going to prepare workers for the new economy, it was going to require access to higher education. 5 years ago, we were approached by Mid-Atlantic Broadband, Microsoft, and then Hewlett-Packard, because they had been having trouble finding a local workforce for the data centers. And they were bringing in workers from Raleigh and Richmond, but as someone once told me, you can't import your local workforce. And so they would come, work a year, then they'd go take a job somewhere else. So we got together with that group and approached the Tobacco Commission to provide us with funding that would allow us to establish the IT Academy. And I think what we have done well is we listened to the employers. They told us what they needed, and then we made it happen. And then we've continued that relationship. The folks from Microsoft are just terrific about coming and speaking to our students and doing mock interviews and taking them on tours. And so they have continued to be integrated into what we're doing. And that's a real success story.
Well, the Data Center Academy basically is a tool or a vehicle in which we're able to train individuals from the community to develop skills that are required at the data center, but also give them an opportunity to have a career in technology, whether it's with the data center or not. It actually has a number of components to it that are important. One is a scholarship fund, which supports underrepresented groups, giving them an opportunity to get into the technology field. Another is donated equipment, which allows the schools to be able to set up a mock data center environment that provides hands-on training. Another component is mentorship, where networking and connection with other Microsoft employees can continue to happen for those that come into our internship program. And the internship program is really good because it gives the scholarship students an opportunity to work in the data center for 3 months. The idea is that if there's available positions, they can transition perhaps into full-time employees. But if not, they still have the opportunity to put that real-world experience on a resume, which gives them opportunities elsewhere.
A big part of our training program is the hands-on opportunities that we give the students. And we always need equipment, so Microsoft has really come through for us. Microsoft donated decommissioned data center equipment to the IT Academy. And so we placed it in our data center, and this data center is where the students do all their hands-on work. So they're actually working on data center equipment. They're seeing and touching and working with the very same type of equipment they'll see when they go to work. Microsoft has impacted the community in so many ways, and one of the biggest is actually just locating a data center here in our region, because there's so many jobs that are created. And these people that want to live here can live here now. They don't have to leave to find work. I think that's just really, really huge.
The partnership with Microsoft has been wonderful, and it came about as an employee came and saw this space. And then we began working together to replicate a data center actually in a classroom so that we could teach real world skills and prepare students for that type of work. And since that time, it's just been a wonderful partnership in all aspects. So we've had Microsoft employees to come in and to give us advice on where to place equipment, to tutor our students, to sit in on classes, to give suggestions. It's been a great partnership. I think an institution like this means hope to a lot of people. One of the largest barriers is poverty here. And, you know, it's things that people wouldn't necessarily think of, but you know, for someone to come to college, they have to consider daycare or childcare or even transportation. Just simple gas money sometimes is enough of a barrier to knock someone out of chasing their dreams or chasing their goals. And so the scholarship program has just been phenomenal because when I recruit for this program, I can go in and say, hey, don't worry about it, everything's covered. And that's just such a great feeling, and to let the person know that that barrier is gone.
Before January, I would apply to jobs and I wouldn't get a call back. But now, every job I applied to, someone called me back, and that's a big thing. I used to always think that work was something you would have to break your back over, that you had to do a daily grind in order to achieve what you want and have and be comfortable in your life. But after taking these classes and after receiving all of the opportunities, I found my dream job at 20 years old, and going to work every day is so much fun. I wake up early, I get to work, and then I just don't want to leave. The achievement I am most proud of today is the Microsoft award I received. That really boosted my happiness and my feeling of accomplishment to be recognized by Microsoft themselves personally. That was amazing.
The scholarship to me has been just a tremendous opportunity, and I really appreciate Microsoft for what they've done for the students, me as a student. And being that I'm 3 hours away, it kind of gave me a little more push and drive to take the classes, to be dedicated to the coursework, and to see it through to the end. Because I had so much that I was given, I felt like I had to take that much more on myself to complete the course.
Well, I would like to see that this become a vehicle for individuals to find their way into Microsoft as a career. But if that doesn't always happen, I want this education to prepare them for jobs anywhere in the technology field, so that whether they want to stay here at home and work for a small business, work for the school, start their own IT business, or travel somewhere else, I want them to be able to have the skill set to be able to go out and compete in the technology world.